No one who owns a car needs statistics to tell them that it costs a bomb to run these days. But even the most budget-minded motorist may be surprised at just how much his costs have gone up during the last few months. Take, for example, the findings of the AA, published recently in Drive. Their index of motoring costs for 1979 show that the average family man spent £696. Now that's £90 more than he spent in 1978. £70 of that was taken up with the increase in the cost of petrol, but even so, the drivers in this group drove 600 miles less in 79 than they did in 78. And then there's the RAC, their latest schedule of running costs, say that someone who's running a car of 4.5 litres or more now and doing about 10,000 miles a year actually has to find 92 pence a mile to cover all the costs necessary just to keep his car on the road. And if he only does 5,000 miles a year, well then that cost goes up to an astronomical £1.53 a mile. Do you remember when we used to worry about petrol being £1 a gallon? But then those are the biggest cars on the road. Now if we come down the scale to a 1300 car, like this Escort for instance, you can reckon that your road tax, insurance, depreciation, the interest on the capital you've tied up, your garaging and parking, as well as petrol, oil and maintenance, will be costing you something like 24 pence a mile. And again, that's on the basis of 10,000 miles a year. So how would you like to cut your fuel bill by something over £200 a year? Well, that is the saving which the RAC claim can be made by following a simple 5-point plan. And with me, I have Ron Naylor from the RAC. And Ron, perhaps you can start off by just briefly telling us what those 5 points are.
Well, simply by making sure that the tyres are properly inflated, removing a roof rack when not in use, taking out any necessary weight luggage from the car, making sure that the engine is properly tuned, and then just simply going easy on the accelerator pedal.
Well, before we look at those 5 points in more detail, we've decided to set up our own test, and for that we have two identical Escorts. Both have had accurate fuel consumption meters fitted to them by RAC engineers, but there the similarity ends. One has been thoroughly serviced and tuned and has had new plugs and points fitted. The other has around 14,000 miles on the clock and is due for a routine service. One has correctly inflated tyres, the other's tyres are £1 down all round. One has no roof rack, the other does. One has nothing in the boot, but the other has some £60 of clobber which could well be cleared out. And finally, one is being driven by a practiced economy driver, while the other will be driven by John Miles, a familiar figure from the RAC, who's not going to worry too much about how heavily he presses with his right foot. So we're going to send the two cars out on an identical route, and when they come back we'll be able to see just what sort of difference there is in their fuel consumption. But Ron, coming back to the 5 points, what sort of tests did you mount in order to establish that plan?
Well, we took an average family car, 6 years old, and we ran it on, had all the faults wrong with it, and then we ran it on 10 gallons of petrol, and we got 242 miles to that 10 gallon. Then we corrected all the faults and we ran it again, and that's when we started to see the difference.
Well, starting off with tyres, presumably you can't play around too much with the manufacturer's recommended tyre pressure.
Oh no, you've got to stick to the figures recommended by the manufacturer, but there can be quite a variance there. For example, on the Escort, it can vary between 24, normal laden, and 36, fully laden. So if you run on the 36, you're okay, and you can get quite a saving there.
Does it matter what sort of tyres you use?
Well, radial is the best, but as most cars are fitted with those these days, so there's not much motorists have to worry about too much in that direction.
So on your car, when you sorted out the tyres, what sort of saving did you make?
3 extra miles.
Right, so moving on to the roof rack, presumably it's not the weight of the roof rack which is important, is it?
No, it's the interference it has with the aerodynamics. It interferes with the flow of air, and this is where you get the drag.
So you took off the roof rack, and how many extra miles did you
11
add
11 extra miles.
Which is quite significant, really,
well,
isn't
we
it?
We were surprised at that.
Now, you were talking about extra rubbish. I know we all carry around a lot. What were you thinking of in particular?
Well, I think there's lots of things that a motorist does carry in his boot, which doesn't have to be there all the time. Things left over from the odd day out or the weekend away. And if he just sort of looks at it very carefully and throws out what he doesn't really want, he'd be surprised at the amount of weight he can reduce.
So when you took all of your rubbish out, what did you add to your mileage?
Well, we added another 21 miles.
Right. Well, let's move on to servicing and tuning. Obviously, this is a very important area, isn't it?
Extremely so. This is where you can really save some miles. And it's a simple thing by making sure that the plugs are properly adjusted and clean, that the points have got the, again, properly adjusted. And that the thing is serviced properly, the whole car is nicely serviced, and serviced at the right time, and this is where you can be saved.
So after a proper service, how many miles did you add then?
Well, we retuned the whole thing, and we got another 43 miles.
Now, while we're on the subject of engines and servicing, what about the thin oils? There's been a lot of publicity about them.
There has, but here again, we would recommend people to go to the manufacturer to make sure before they start using. But really, this is where the only instance where they can save this is really on the cold stop-start running. This is where they're going to find the benefit.
I should think most important of all is economy driving. Can you just briefly tell us what that is?
Well, this is really where we did save a big amount, and it's gently on the right foot. No harsh acceleration, harsh braking, gently all the time, and that's the key word, and we saved quite a bit.
And how much did you save, in fact?
73 extra miles.
Which is a tremendous amount. Very good advice. Yeah. Ron, thanks very much indeed. So there you are, that makes a total of an extra 151 miles on 10 gallons of petrol. And our two cars are just about to arrive back, so let's go and see what the results are. Okay, Mike, thanks very much indeed. Okay, well, you have to bear in mind that the test we've done here is a very quick one, nowhere near as thorough as the RAC's own test, but even so, the difference is very noticeable. The car with the adjustments would do 92 miles more on 10 gallons of petrol than the car without it, and that really is a very significant saving. But while we're on the subject of saving petrol, for the first time really since the fuel crisis really took a grip, one of the major motoring manufacturers is announcing this week a new engine which has been designed especially with economy in mind. And this is obviously going to be a trend for the future, and perhaps with car manufacturers playing their part in this way, and with us as drivers also making sure that we're more economy minded, well, perhaps our motoring costs don't need to be quite so frightening in the future.